Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm Serious JG. Last time when we finished a week's worth of uploads, okay, Trevor, there's a feller. The next feller's the worst kind of criminal there is, a banker. Looking at some of the videos he posted online, he fancies himself a bit of an ad. Adrenaline junkie
Finance guy, my favorite.
and a celebrity on the side, so it'll be a real pleasure to put behind bars. All right. Well, I was gonna say, oh, hold on, let's get out of the house. I was gonna say, last time we were thinking we could do the Minutemen. Sort of Strangers and Freaks mission. We could do stock manipulation, or we could get back to the main story. And I kind of had not even thought about the possibility of doing this. Well, because I didn't have it yet. This. Glenn Scoville. I have to assume that he's up here someplace. He's an adrenaline junkie, they said, right? I think he's at the top of the cable cars, actually. Let's just see if we can find him up at the cable cars. Checking to see if we have I don't think we've got a like a parachute. I guess we'd want to have one. I vaguely remember one of the guys you chase for these missions. He does like a paradrop jump, and you would be well advised to. You can either shoot him from a distance, or he jumps and activates a parachute, and you have to follow him that way to take
Just
him
when I thought
alive.
my day couldn't get any worse. What kind
Oh.
of welcome is that, Melvin? You really are a pitiful example of a man.
Yeah.
I've just had a bad day. Don't need to be bullied by you right now.
Why are you so miserable? I mean, it doesn't make for a dynamic store experience.
Well, I live alone. I don't have any real friends to speak of.
Oh, a weird loner who runs a gun store.
I don't actually want to know.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm thinking like, I thought I would come here to buy parachute, but maybe not. Because you can't actually buy knives in this game. Buy armor. Oh, never mind. There it is.
I hate my life. You know things are bad when Ma turns you down for a date.
Ugh.
Enjoy.
All right, well that means I've got a. Okay, it's that bottom corner. Like I knew there was some indication whether or not you have. I'm not gonna bother to buy armor. If we need armor in a mission, it'll probably be provided. Or, you know what? I shouldn't assume that, but also, ah, fuck. We've got millions of dollars. Let's buy armor that will gradually get shot off during random bullshit and not be around when we need it for a story mission.
It's the closest that you can get to invincibility. Hope that works out for you.
Whiskey River, don't run dry. You're all I got to carry me. Anyway, yeah, I think we want to go to here. That's interesting. It I would have thought this would have been the shortest way to get up there. Tell you what, we'll do the Minutemen mission while we're up here. I would have thought it would be shorter to go like this way. But game don't seem to think so. I'm gonna go against the game's advice and we'll see just how bad these roads are here and whether or not the game is right to try to have me go the long way around on the coastal highway. Because it's not like I'm not gonna be driving at highway speeds on whatever roads. But if it's a bunch of like boreens, as they say, windy country roads that I'm gonna like fly off of and crash going at speed. I'm not playing as Franklin, so I don't have like super slow down time driving power. I think this may be a bad idea to do this, but I mean, we'll get there. Trouble today with women. Yeah, this is where you get to the why did you think you should come on these roads instead of going on the highway? But I mean, as long as it's multiple car widths here, it's fine. Anyway, I'm in that mode. I'm playing on Sunday evening. Like, I had dinner, I got my steps in for the day, although a few more steps. I skipped, first time all year. It was the day after my birthday. On my birthday, I didn't play a bunch of GTA, but I did. This is the series where I talk about alcohol. I did actually go out and drink on my birthday. So the day after my birthday, I was feeling a little under the weather, and I did not get my steps in. So now I have to. I'm going for more than 10,000 steps a day for the next, like, you know, just a couple extra steps each day, so I can have cover the steps I didn't get. Here's where. Probably the game figures you're better off going on the highway for a slightly longer or more less direct trip that doesn't involve probably flying off a cliff. These roads aren't too bad. Anyway, sorry. No, but I probably. What the? Is that a commercial? I don't know what that radio nonsense was. There are hikers. Oh, this is a nature trail that we're like. But anyway, yeah, it's like the first time all year I didn't get my steps. I got to get extra steps. I already got some today. Why am I talking about this? Because it's Sunday evening and it's like terrible time to Let's Play because your Let's Play videos in theory are saved forever on the internet, and it's something you're doing when you're in that like just kind of gross. Next time I put my head down and go to sleep, when I wake up, I'm gonna have to go to work the next day. Mode. Ah, see, here's the other reason that it's probably not a great idea to come this way. Okay, never mind. There's a quick way to get up on that highway. I was looking at it, I was like, how the hell do I get up there? It's not too bad. Oh, after all this. This game has, like, anti-rolling physics. It really, really favors your vehicle landing on its wheels in a way that prior games didn't. So, like, yeah, I definitely rolled that thing, and the game was like, give the kid a break. As he just said, it's Sunday night. He's in a bad mood. He's got to work the next day. I guess, see, Hookie's Bar, that's, I would normally, oh, these are the law, so they're hostile. So there goes some of that armor I bought already. And if I was role-playing properly as Trevor, I would go do something about them, but I just don't care. Even though, whoa, there's a car just, like, phased out of reality there on the, you see that on the left? Why do I have a CD radio? I'm getting like weird random CD radio shit. CB radio, not CD. Miss me. The only thing about armor in this game is I don't think I can just go... There aren't really free armor picks up, but on the hen house, can you send someone to the bar? We got a big problem. Oh, well. Okay, so we're actually on our way, and I don't know that we've done any missions like this, so... A big problem with the local gang. This may be the lost, actually. I wonder if the game actually sort of realized we were heading towards the bar and gave us a bar mission to do. We passed by Hookies. And back in the day, I would definitely have bought that with Trevor, but now I'm like, I... For Let's Play purposes, I'm not sure if there's a point in me buying most of these properties. Take out the Kapangi attacking the bar. All right, well. Well, the armor is all gone. What the hell? Is that guy hot? Like, he wasn't in my way, and then he swung over and got in my way. I've got some gang members who I think if I don't take them out, I still lose money at the bar, but... Cops are in the way. This is definitely not a good use of our time. I just... Because we're mostly dead now, and we've... Well, wait a minute. Did we just get a... So I think we failed the, I think those gang members were considered to have escaped. I don't know how, because I was chasing them. Or maybe they got wiped out in a car accident that I didn't see, but I'm pretty sure we just failed to help the bar. Now I don't know how I gotta try to get away from the cops in this vehicle, which is not that fast. Well, it's actually faster than it looks like it would be, but I don't know that I'm going to outrun the cops very well. We've got cops coming up ahead, so it's to my advantage to get off the main road. This may go my way, in fact. The stars are flashing. I guess they're still looking. All right. Now I've officially evaded. We've got a lot of cleaning up to do over here. Yeah, like that didn't count as me. I got in there, like a huge fight went on, killed a bunch of dudes, did not count as me preventing them from doing the damage. So we failed that mission, but you saw what it entailed. A bunch of hostiles, and you have a very limited time to take them out. The cops will be drawn to you as you're shooting up the place, and even as you're chasing them and you can clearly see them, they suddenly just stop being marked, and the mission is considered a failure. So okay, well now Well, he seems to be fleeing on foot, which is why I got out of this vehicle. Maybe I shouldn't have. Pardon me, sir. Alright, that was my good deed for the day, right? 500 bucks. Which means nothing. I don't know why I feel compelled. I guess it's just a woman screaming for help. I feel like I should do something, but in this world, that means killing someone. But she said her life was in this wallet, so. Meanwhile, my car is now lost forever because it's not marked on the map.
Hello there.
Hello there.
He saw the error of his ways.
Who says chivalry is dead? I only wish more people were like you today.
So she gave me 50 bucks. But I got a full special meter. I think I found that out somewhere for doing a good deed, which means nothing. Cambio checks. Envio de dinero. Check cashing, liquor, hot coffee. Yeah. I could see wanting to run a little place like, as long as you owned it, like having a little business like that with this just random shit that it did. Somebody just yelled cocksucker. What happened to the, okay, the Minuteman mission disappeared for a bit. That's what we actually came up here to do. Toledo Bay. Seems like a nice little town with its. What the?
That man's a racist, everyone!
Oh, this is dialogue from the Minutemen missions that are nearby. Like, that was just.
He victimizes all men!
You guys drop any money? Oh, I just accidentally started the mission.
Except that they paid me some money.
That must feel good. What a proud patriot you are.
Uh-huh. I wasn't ready to do this. I was going to look around at the scene of cops shooting a bunch of dudes.
My family has been here 200 years. I'm more American than you. Not that it's anything to boast about.
Oh, you know, Canadian. I mean.
Well, at least you got paid.
Don't get all serious, okay? Anybody can make a mistake.
Perhaps now you want to kill me.
Yeah, maybe, old man. Maybe not.
You and your Civil Border Patrol friends, you're all the same. Ignorant fools trying to protect something that's not even there.
They're not my friends.
I just took 50 bucks from them and did some zany missions.
It's one of fucking people I don't like, all right? It's one of my favorite hobbies.
Border Patrol, man.
Fuck you! You want to fucking die?
You don't scare me. You owe my family a great debt.
What?
Land is no longer safe.
Not my fault.
You're so concerned. Clean it up for me. Your choice. And no, I will not give you 1 cent.
So I guess we deported his son or something? I'm not even sure.
I heard your Civil Border Patrol friends were boarding some people east of here at the San Cudo farm. Go left on Ocean Highway, you'll see them.
So this guy just guilt trips us into murdering those other guys. Because, yeah, we just had, you're making a big mistake. Like, this was, I don't know what that previous one was. Oh, but he's saying, get over here, you coward. That man's a racist. Okay. He's guilt tripping us into murdering the guys we did these previous missions for. And I vaguely remember that the Minutemen quest, like, ended randomly and weirdly. But I didn't notice that some dude guilt tripped us into killing them ourselves. Like, I don't think we've known them long enough to really have that much anger built up towards them. I just thought it was a lame joke.
I should never have gotten involved with those nut jobs.
Well, why do you care what this older Mexican-American man making you feel shitty? I mean, all right, whatever. Wait a minute, they're already hostile?
Removed from the gene pool.
Wow, that took no time at all. Okay, so we immediately killed the goofy Middle Eastern one.
Stay out of this, you dumb Canadian! Oh, you just made this real easy for me!
He stole a tractor. Now I'm going to chase him down in a tractor, too, to make it harder than it needs to be. So I think that's part of the point of this, is that it's super easy to kill them. But now I've decided I'm going to go tractor versus tractor.
You want the Second Amendment? I'll give it to you.
Oh, he abandoned his vehicle.
Patrol disbanded.
What goes around, no migration. And we got 19 bucks. So that guy said he wasn't going to pay us. He didn't know we would take 19 bucks from the fallen men and a gun. So that's, yeah, I was like, the whole bullet Minutemen subplot. Just like a lame joke that one of them doesn't even speak English, and then, oh, use a stun gun on them before killing them. Kill them before they leave the farm. Okay. Yeah, I guess we could have stunned them, but whatever. Driving around in a tractor, listening to Dirty White Boy. Dirty white boy. So I want to say that the mission we're doing for Maud. Hey, it's Franklin. I don't know anyone else who drives a pickup truck anywhere in the entire universe. White boy. Dirty white boy. Dirty White Boy's tag team partner was, of course, the wide-eyed Southern boy. We all know that. At one point, the Dirty White Boy had a love interest in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and probably other places, the Dirty White Girl. It was not the same, I believe, as ODB from TNA. Yeah, I'm really, I think at this point, I'm just padding the Let's Play, like, I don't know what I'm going to do to fill the interim if I finish GTA 5 and GTA 6 hasn't come out yet. So I guess I'm just going to make sure that this series takes a while to complete by driving everywhere in a tractor. Now, if I was Franklin, if I was playing as Franklin, we could make this even more awesome by driving a tractor and using his special slow-mo driving power. Driving on the curb, getting passed by other vehicles. This is pretty fun. Alright, well, let's go off-road in our tractor. I don't see any reason not to. Dirty white boy. I believe, now Bobo can correct me when he sees this video sometime in 2036. I believe that the Dirty White Boy and the Wide-Eyed Southern Boy were the Thugs. Now, maybe there's a different tag team called the Thugs. But I believe the Thugs were the Dirty White Boy and the Wide-Eyed Southern Boy. And their slogan was, of course, T is for terrible, H is for hail, U is for ugly, and G is for jail, because the Thugs can't spell. Which is why later on, when we had the joke of there being a team called the New Thugs, their slogan was, T is for terrible, H is for hail, U is for ugly, and G is for jail, because the New Thugs can't spell no better than the old ones could. We are goofy funsters. If you wish to wait, a cable car will arrive here shortly. And we can do the old, man, we are like bloody in the face. We can do the old, Snake's Revenge bit where we just get, riding it on top of a cable car but constantly being spotted. Or not. It's very shiny blood that he has. Suppose while I'm waiting for this cable car to pick us up, I could or to get moving again, because I figured that would happen at some point. Can check and see, with the power of the internet, am I even going to the right place? Glenn Scoville. GTA. Glenn Scoville location. He's at Mount Chiliad. Yeah, okay. So I was actually right. This is the correct place to go. What I'm not quite figuring out is why this cable car isn't in operation. Do I have to go to this cable car? Okay. Like there was some trigger I never got that was supposed to tell us to start the cable car. So we'll skip the ride, as exciting as I'm sure it would be. And when we come back next time, hopefully this means that we will get to do another Bounty Hunter mission. There's only like two left, counting this one. So we'll do one of the two next time, unless this is not the right place to be, in which case, I don't know. Catch you next time.